Welcome to an experience that is supposed to do this and this. But after going through this, hello everyone, it's Kay, your local Gen Z college student that is barely surviving life, is here to give you tips, here to give you advice on things I wish I knew before I attended college. I have watched tons of YouTuber tip videos about how to survive college. It was literally my entire YouTube free page.
Free page?
Yeah, TikTok and YouTube have just been crossing my mind lately, and I don't know how to make the difference between the two. Pretty much on my subscription, I was binging, watching, obsessing over college. Yes, I was that person that romanticized it for tons and tons of months. Is college a little superficial? Is it a little or a lot capitalistic? Yes, it is. It is. It's John Mulaney's world, and we're just living in it. But without further ado, let's get into it. First off, college is nothing like the movies, nor is it the institutions that your parents or peers attended. I don't know what type of magical wonderland college was when my peers were going to school, and of course we can attribute COVID to that, but let's be honest, college is not the perfect fun social scene that everyone makes it out to be on Instagram. It can be very tough and difficult and not as aesthetically pleasing as you see on YouTube. I feel like once you get that admission that you got into a school and you're super excited, super enthusiastic, so appreciative that you were able to get into an institution, that fun, positive vibe just comes in,
rushes in.
In hindsight, is kind of deceiving because you haven't really experienced college level work. And once you have received it,
it's a whole other beast.
Registration. So this is specifically gonna target my Drake University peer watcher. I know it's probably similar to most universities, but the only experience that I can really tell y'all is my school. So once you've chosen your major and you get your acceptance letter, the first thing that you're gonna wanna do is fill out that intake survey they give you. It's crucial that you fill that out as fast as you can. Otherwise, you're literally gonna get thrown into classes, which is not fun because you're only gonna get whatever is left. And don't be surprised if you don't have a lot of major classes your first semester and you have a lot of intro classes. And by intro classes, I mean your first year seminar and the one class that every single student at Drake hates. After you filled out that intake survey and you're finally kind of starting to figure out what you want to study, please, please, please download a PDF of your checklist. It basically shows you everything that you need to fill out for your AOI, general education requirements, majors. So that is extremely crucial when you're first starting to look at what you're going to be taking for your fall semester, because that might change based on what your advisor gives you, because you don't want to be taking pointless classes. I was very adamant on not taking any sort of gen ed classes because it's too much money that we're paying, and to be paying it for classes that you're not really going to be using in a job is just ridiculous and stupid. In terms of like dropping and adding classes, which of course is like pretty normal because you get thrown into classes pretty much last minute as a freshman, I would recommend you check how many credits you're taking. Normally, your advisor, if they're, you know, sane, will give you about 14 to 15 credits just to kind of start you out. But if you're someone that likes to be an overachiever and take 18 credits, you might want to add a class, or you might want to ask your advisor if that's even a good idea. Because I think as a freshman, advisors just kind of throw things together, and even if you have like AP or IB credit, they probably will pull you into classes that you probably don't even need to take. So be mindful of that when you're trying to drop and add classes. You also only get about like a week before Drake kind of just says
no.
And by no, they means give you like an L in your transcript by trying to get into another class, which is not fun. You don't want to do that. Because I almost did that and it wasn't fun. Okay, this is kind of like transitioning into something I just talked about earlier, but trying to transfer college level credit into Drake is a pain. I was talking with people in my journalism classes and they were having so much trouble trying to transfer college credit to Drake. So y'all need to send your AP credit, College Board stuff to the admissions office
immediately.
And immediately, I mean like after you watch this video. I don't know what it is about their admission system. They just don't process credit easily unless it's like from a community college or something. But if it's like something like AP or IB credit, you're gonna have to email them like every 5 minutes because they will not receive it until you basically email them to the point where they're like, okay, we need to fix this because Drake sometimes isn't as responsive as they probably should be. Now moving on to academics. At Drake, there are the AOIs, which stands for Area of Inquiry, aka General Education Requirements, and there are quite a lot of them. Surprisingly, I wasn't even expecting this, but since I'm in the honors program, it's basically cut in half for me. Let's talk about professors. I think specifically at Drake, we have really good professors. They're extremely understanding, especially if you need an extension, if you have like a little creative idea for a project. They are so friendly. Also, Rate My Professor is your best friend. You'll basically get to see what students have rated their professor as, if they really liked them, if they really hated them, if they're really hard. Now also keep in mind that this can be very, very biased in terms of students like not wanting to do any work or put any time into anything. Or it can be like the students that are very studious and just think like, oh, the professor is just a little tough, or they need to improve on this, or they're not really sociable. I would definitely take Rate My Professor with a grain of salt, but also kind of keep it in mind because it's just not wise to go into something blind. I did not use Rate My Professor as much as I probably should have. This semester, I'm definitely using it because I'm not getting stacked with a professor that is extremely difficult. Because I had some horror flashbacks that one of my honors classes gave me. Now, let's talk about time management. Time management is crucial. Mega, 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 mega crucial. If you don't have good time management skills, you're not gonna survive. Especially when you're in new environments, trying to adjust to different time schedules if you're not in state, and trying to manage your entire academic and extracurricular schedule. It's just not possible. So one thing, of course, I would recommend is getting a planner. If you don't have one already, buy one. If you don't wanna buy a planner, use Notion. Have something where you're writing stuff down. At least somewhere where it's visible, because if you don't, you're gonna be behind on assignments, you're not gonna turn in stuff, and then you're gonna miss meetings, and it's just gonna make your life a lot more miserable than it already is probably gonna be. Also, you will hear this term at Drake pretty darn often, Drake busy. Basically, Drake students, they like to overwork themselves. And by overwork themselves, I mean overcommit themselves. They want to put themselves in Greek life, sports, and clubs, and be in honors, and do a bunch of classes that make them think hard or take 18 credits. That's actually very prevalent on Drake's campus. Like, do not be surprised if you hear a lot of students saying they're taking 18 credits. Just know your own limits and don't feel peer pressured to take more than what you can handle. I think that was a crucial thing for me because I'm always someone that likes to people please or tries to keep up with everyone because I always kind of feel like I'm never good enough. But try not to put that in your brain too much. It's just not wise to put yourself in such a mental strain where you're literally panicking and crying every night about the loads amount of stress that's on your plate. Another thing that will help you keep yourself accountable is make friends with your class. It's what's gonna help you survive. If you're someone that's extremely quiet in class, it's not gonna really work too well in college because I feel like college, in a way, is designed to make you work with other people and not just with group projects because you're gonna have a lot more of those, but the classes are just difficult. They're not high school. Cramming is not gonna work in college. So study with friends. Enjoy people. Especially since COVID hopefully will start to get a little bit better. And I know that for Drake students, we were able to be on campus this whole entire year. I mean, it's pretty much the face of my channel at this point, so. Dorm life. Which, there's a lot to that. And it was pretty interesting this year, especially since I lived in a residence hall. That was a little... You will encounter very, 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 very quickly that dorm life will be completely different than how it is normally. Of course, with this whole pandemic, everything's just gotta be so much harder and more difficult and just distanced from other people. With my school, they basically had us go in 2-hour increments. So we had about 2 hours to get there, unpack, and to our parents out. When you get to your dorms, I would recommend before you do anything is to disinfect the entire room. And I know Drake does a pretty good job with keeping everything clean, but there are critters that like to make appearances in the room while you're eating, working on a paper, or just trying to enjoy silence from a really hard day. And also make your room a place where you don't want to die. Especially since this whole past year has been fully remote, at least for me. I only had one class this semester that was in person. So I had to make sure that my dorm was nice and decked out and something that was gonna make me wanna work. If you wanted to see what my dorm was last semester, that is in a dorm room tour video that I will link in the cards up there. Cause trust me, I looked on YouTube, I've looked online. There is rarely anything that is shown on Drake. Communal bathrooms. Yes, they're a serious problem. They're not fun. They're not terrible, but they're not fun. My advice is to get in and get out. Buy shower shoes. You don't want to walk barefoot on those disgusting bathroom tiles. Many people walk on barefoot, haven't washed. Drake students are very, very lucky. Them janitor people are beautiful. The bathrooms are not bad at all. In the mornings, they're like so clean. They don't smell like sweat. With communal bathrooms, when you're taking a shower, find a caddy that you can hang up. I know with Drake dorms, they have like a little stall where you can actually put your toiletries, your shower caddy on, which is nice. They don't really have a place where you hang it, but I recommend to hang it because I don't think y'all want to put your stuff on that stall because I'm sure people sit on it and do stuff on it, so I wouldn't do it even though it is provided. Roommates. Drake does it pretty similarly to other schools, but it's mainly through their system, so you don't have to worry about having to like find someone last minute. But with freshmen, you kind of just get roomed with whoever. Until sophomore year, you get to pretty much pick who you want to be with. If it doesn't work out, let people know. Don't just hide it, because there were people on my floor that were just
No.
So with Drake dorms, they're not very big. What Drake kind of likes to do with students, they kind of like to yeet their students by like junior year. And by yeet, I mean they don't really consider them in the dorms anymore. You can pretty much either go to West Village, which is basically right next to Drake's campus. It's where like the subway and the 8 degree, which is where you can get boba. Dining. Hubble. What can I even say about that place? It's not terrible, but it's not great either. I would like to say it's a middle ground between being decent and just not being great. It's tolerable at most. They basically serve pretty much the same thing all week. They serve like pizza, salad, burger, fries, pretty much every day. They sometimes have like ravioli, which is okay. They have the grill. Quick tip, anything by the grill, please get it. I know the line might be long, but it's worth it because the food there compared to that is like completely different entities. They serve rice and chicken or noodles and chicken and beef. On weekends, they serve omelets and hash browns, and they actually have decent stuff on the weekends. Also, take advantage of the C-store. I did not use the C-store at all. It was really bad. I only used it nearing the end of last semester. Take advantage of it. They actually have some decent stuff over there. Basically, it's like a Walgreens or like a small little Walmart that you can go to and get food. The social scene. Kinda already talked about it here, but Drake has a decent social scene. If you're thinking that you're gonna get lit like some state school,
it's not gonna happen.
Drake in some ways is a little preppy in terms of like being academic, career focused, trying to get in and get out. Like you'll find a lot of people like that at Drake. You're not gonna find people that are gonna party or spend time with people every single day because Drake is a pretty rigorous school academically. So you're not gonna be able to just party every weekend. There will be some of those crackheads that will party every weekend. Know your own limits because at the end of the day, you gotta turn in that paper, you gotta turn in that assignment, you gotta do that homework. And I don't know what it is about a lot of people and Greek life, but I know Drake has a decent Greek life scene. I think it's like almost 60% of the campus is involved in Greek life, so it is quite a lot. Y'all don't need to be in Greek life to make friends. I know it's like such a stigma. If you're not in Greek life, then you're like missing out on a whole bunch of stuff. That is so not true. Drake students are pretty friendly. Get involved in clubs, get off campus. because I was someone that always stayed in their dorm, there's actually, surprisingly, a few things to do in Des Moines. We have a pretty big mall, we have movie theater, we have some pretty good restaurants, so get your butt off campus and do stuff sometimes. Taking a break is very necessary. I remember I had one of my best friends at Drake. I always called her like all the time, and she would basically be coaching me on how to calm down and stay in the moment, and it is so crucial to stay in the moment in college. Don't think about what you're gonna be doing junior and senior year, because it's just gonna stress the freak you out. Drake is very much a school that doesn't like to be in trouble, likes to be looked at positively. That's why they make you fill out a very extensive survey on alcohol, drinking, prevention, and ethics. It's very long, and you probably have already started it. You're gonna have to be your own self-motivator. You cannot expect anyone to force you to work. You cannot expect anyone to push you into making friends or getting involved in clubs. You gotta do it yourself. And if you don't do it yourself, you're gonna be in the position that I was in, barely making friends in, a month and a half. A month and a half in, I was closed off, not really engaging with others, and it did cause detriments into me trying to make actual friends. Be as thoughtful and as open and as engaging as possible so that you actually have a decent experience. Get a job on campus. You will be very shocked about how many students at Drake have a job. And I know this is pretty much universal for all colleges. I would almost say 70 to 80% of Drake students have a job. It is the easiest way to make friends. It is the easiest way to make money, because college already puts you in such a broke financial state. You gotta have spending money, especially if you wanna be in clubs, you wanna do stuff with friends. It is so easy to get a job at Drake. Comparing it to like other competitive private schools or even some public schools that are just ginormous, it is easy to get a job. Just fill out an application. I'm not sure what the site is called. I'll probably have it on the screen somewhere. And finally, what I'm gonna leave with is enjoy the experience. College is short and sweet. So enjoy all the experiences that you make, friends that you gain, and everything that just comes your way. Because college can be definitely difficult. I know that it's hard to be surrounded by super smart, intelligent people and people from literally everywhere. Ugh, and we are finally done. That's gonna wrap it up for today. I hope this information was helpful, because I feel like there's just nothing on YouTube about Drake. I will see y'all in the next video. Bye.